boring. Like, I gotta look at it. It's cool. I'm good. How y'all doing tonight? How y'all doing? My name is Nandibcomedy. I just came from LA and performed in front of celebrities for the first time. And I did kind of good. I did kind of good. So I'm excited to come back. If you don't know me, I used to be a hetero addict. If you don't know what that is, I'm a recovering heterosexual. That's just my thing. If you don't know what that means, back in the day, I used to just take dick and take dick and take dick until it just overwhelmed me. I couldn't do it anymore. So I decided to go to what's best for me. This is what's best for me. And I still get confused sometimes when people ask me to send them a picture. I'm like, bitch, just look in the mirror. I don't, there's nothing special about you. Now, that's how it is. That's how it is. So when I was younger, I didn't get a lot of shit that everybody else got. I was broke. I wore shacks a lot. That's just the shit that I did. I wore shacks. But I didn't talk shit about it because people didn't talk shit about me. When I be in school, they be like, she got shacks on. She got shacks on. I was like, no, these aren't shacks. These are JRMXs. You look, take a close look. Your Jake's fine, he's about to dunk it. My dude already dunked it. You lived in the past. Let's just talk about that. You have to wait in line for your shit, all of that, okay? So I don't have to do that. Alright? I get confused about how I am, my sexuality sometimes. My friends still make it seem like when I turn gay, like I grew a penis or some shit. Like, you know how you have your junk night with your friends, at least one bitch pees outside the car. Okay, one bitch. So all my friends talking about, we about to pee, babe. Like, Nani, she can stand up. So we ain't gotta worry about her. I'm like, bitch, what? Then when I came to work, I walk in the bathroom and Muslim lady was like, oh my God, Nandi, every time you come here, you scare me. I just get scared every time you come here. I don't get offended. I'm like, I don't get offended because when I first seen you, I thought you were a terrorist. So, I just never got to play with you, is what I'm saying. I was never going to fucking play with you, okay? That's just how it is. But I'm not racist. I'm not racist because I watch white porn all the time. So y'all can just cut that out of the picture, okay? I do that, all right? I'm not embarrassed to say that I watch porn. I'm not. I get scared because sometimes when I'm watching it, I feel like Jesus or one of my dead aunts is watching me. So I like to turn the shit off. Alright? But I command the porn people. I do back pages. Some of y'all got in. I command them because it's a lot of sex involved. Like, it's sex and sex and sex. And I can just never do that again in my life. So I command them. Alright? I can take a couple STDs for a check if they're curable. They're curable. Hey, you're pushing it. Okay? But I do it, but it's saying for a check. You gotta be compatible with people that you date. I got a couple of messages before an accident. It wasn't my fault. I forgive myself when it happened. You have to be compatible. If you ever got shot, make sure you date somebody that got shot. I don't know what the fuck to do. If somebody came up to the door, first of all, I'm gonna be selfish. Because if you come up to the door and be like, I got shot, I'm like, hey, where are you shot at? No, where are you shot at? Alright, so I don't got that much time. 5 minutes is not that much. So I'm just lead on with this. Next time you complain about your life, just know, okay, there is. Don't steal my shit. To be born. So next time you complain about your life and you say, you know, my life is shitty, I wish I was never here, think about all those kids that are laying on somebody's bed or in their blood or in their teeth.
Oh my God.